Hello, today we are going to change the swing arm on your scooter for the rear side. And in this video, I'm going to show you how. Well, hello everybody. Today we're going to change the swing arm. Unfortunately, my swing arm on the rear side is broken in two parts. One part where you are attached to the exhaust, and the other part is underneath where it really forcing the spring of the shock right here, okay? So on this side. I tried to weld a few times, but it looked like it's not, you know, staying in position. So I decided to buy a new one, and this one came from partsforscooter.com. Pretty good price, on around the $40 range, even less, I think $36, and it looks pretty good, okay? So go to the website, they have a lot of parts for your scooter, okay? And is they have everything. I see that you can get lost in all the things that they have in the website. So partsforscooters.com. I'm going to put the link right underneath on the description. So if you like to go there, if you need any parts, feel free to shopping from them. They have a really fast shipping and good quality product, I can tell you. Okay, let's put this one on the scooter. To put this swing arm, you have to remove a lot of things in the scooter. You have to remove, the lower part of the shock. It's better if you remove the exhaust so you have a little more room, to do that. And to remove the swing arm, let's remove all these parts right here. Now, try to keep the scooter on a center stand when you do a job like this, okay? So if you can keep the scooter on a center stand, you have a better stability if you're pushing the scooter. And you know, there's a lot of many things that can happen if you don't have your scooter on the center stand, okay? Unfortunately, I don't have a center stand for a few reasons, but it's okay, I will be careful. Okay, let's start it. First thing, you're gonna need a few wrenches, few socket. You know, the thing is most popular, especially to remove the exhaust, is a 14 millimeter, okay? That's one you're gonna need. Then you're gonna need a 12 millimeter. Usually it's for this part right here of your swing arm, right? This is a 12 millimeter, this is a 12 millimeter, and back here, you have a 24 millimeter, okay? Down here. So this is very important. Right here at the shock, you're going to need a 12 millimeter right here, okay? So those are the most popular things that you're gonna need, the most popular socket for disassemble everything. That's what you're going to need, okay? So let's start to the job. The first thing we're gonna do, we're gonna remove the exhaust, okay? To remove the exhaust, you're gonna need a 10 millimeter socket to remove the underneath the bolts underneath the motor, okay? So a 10 millimeter socket. Okay, the first thing we're going to remove, we're going to remove this exhaust. This exhaust, I bought it on Amazon. The first thing I didn't like it, because it's making like an off-road bike sound for a scooter. It's kind of strange, but at night, I really love it. These things make fire from the back. It's popping like a Mustang, okay? So during the day, I really don't like it, but at night time is fun. This exhaust right here is really lots of fun, okay? At night time. Anyway, first thing, we're going to remove this exhaust. This one has only one bracket right here to hold, and it's got a 14 millimeter right here, 14 millimeter bolt, and it's got another 12 millimeter bolt down here. This is another location. Now, first thing, we're going to remove the two bolts that are underneath your scooter that holds on, holds down to your exhaust, okay? And you're going to need a 10 millimeter. Those are two bolts that you have underneath your motor for the exhaust system, okay? At this point, to remove this exhaust, you're going to need a 40 millimeter right here to remove this part. That will be the bracket. The 40 millimeter socket. Okay, right after you remove the bracket, make sure you put the bolt somewhere where you're going to find it later, okay? Don't lose it. At this point, you can remove this exhaust. Make sure to don't spread this bracket wide, okay? Just release it and then go back where is a smaller part of your exhaust and you come out from there. If you open this one, they don't have a really good memories. They don't come back the way it was, nice and round, okay? So you will have a hard time, or it might break, okay? They're not great quality, these brackets, okay? So right after you remove this one, put them on the side. At this point, you can remove your exhaust, okay? See, this one is a nice exhaust. I'm not sure how long this one is going to last, but I hope a little bit. See, they come with a little two brackets, right? One up here and one down here. These two brackets, this one on top, you just have to cut it, because this one, it doesn't not allow to remove your dipstick. You cannot remove your dipstick to check your oil, so you have to remove the part right here. The part down here, after a little bit, it breaks down. Okay, so not many exhausts are really good for these scooters, okay? So you can spend a lot of money and find maybe like an Italian-made exhaust for the scooter. At that point, maybe they're gonna last a lot longer. But if not, not many products are made their good way for this scooter, okay? So at this point, after you remove the exhaust, you have a full view of your rear swing arm, okay? So down here you have a 12 millimeter. Up here you have a 12 millimeter. And here we have a 14 millimeter. Some scooter they have 10 millimeter here, okay? So you only really move one, two, three, and you need to remove this one, the shock that is back here that is 12 millimeter. Plus you need to remove the big bolt right here from your back tire, and this one is a 24 millimeter. But for this one, you're going to need a impact wrench drive, okay? You can have a 12 volt impact driver, or you can have a little more nicer, with a little more expensive impact wrench. Those are, you come with a battery or can come with a wire, you know, electrical. So, or you can even use the one that really nice with the compressor to remove this one. So you need to have an impact wrench, okay? So let's keep doing what we're doing. Okay, to remove this one right here, you're going to need a 12 millimeter socket to remove the lower bolt right here. When you loosen a little bit, you can unscrew by hand, okay? Make sure you put it in a location where you're going to remember the screw. Where is it going to go later? This one is a long screw, okay? After you move the one down here, you can unscrew this one. That's another 12 millimeter. Another screw that is right here, okay? This is a bolt, long bolt. This is on the top part of your swing arm, okay? Now, the one on the bottom and the one on the top, they're the same, okay? Same. They're long the same, okay? Now, after this one, you have to remove this part right here. This is a 14 millimeter. So you have a socket that is 14 millimeter. And you can remove the top part, okay? Okay. Right after you remove the screw right here, we're going to remove the screw that is at your shock, okay? This one is a 12 millimeter. It's a long bolt of 12 millimeter. 12 millimeter socket right here, we're going to unscrew. Sometimes they're kind of hard, so be gentle. Be gentle with the screw and all the parts, okay? Because I can tell you, these scooters, I love it, but there is only one problem. The quality of the scooter is not the best quality ever, okay? So, be nice, be gentle, be polite with the scooter. Okay, after you remove this bolt, just put the spring up a little bit and remove the screw, the bolt, and you push this spring back inside, okay? Now put this one somewhere where you're going to remember, okay? Don't lose it. At this point, to remove this swing arm, the last thing you have is the bolt right here. It's 24 millimeter, okay? To remove this one is a 24 millimeter. I have 15-16 right here. 15-16 is like 24 millimeter, okay? Now, to remove this one, you're going to need an impact wrench. This one is a 12 volt impact wrench. It's not even the best of the best, but it does the work. I use it once in a while. I don't suggest you to buy this one if you use it every day, but if you use it one time every 6 months, that's okay. It's gonna last you 3 years, 5 years, you know? So once in a while when you need to remove a large bolt, or once in a while when you need to use it with your scooter, okay? Sometimes you can want to remove the variator with this one, you can remove the clutch from the scooter. This one is really helpful. It's about $30 online. I can put a link underneath and you can buy if you need it, okay? Now, on my scooter, I have a 12 volt outlet that I put a long time ago. You can look one of my video, and I put a 12 volt outlet. That's very useful, especially for tools, okay? Sometimes you can charge your phone too, or your iPhone and everything. You can do a lot of things, okay? So with this one, I can put it right here. That's where I put the outlet on my scooter. It's right underneath the seat of the scooter. And I can use my impact wrench. Now, this one. Make sure when you unscrew, your impact wrench is going to turn left, okay? Not right. Because right, you're gonna tighten more that big nut right there. So you have to turn left, okay? So, this time you can place it right here. Thank you. I have the big mat right here, inside there. And at this point, your swing arm is free, okay? So this is the large mat. So this is the large mat that is in the back of your tire, okay? This one is a 24 millimeter, okay? You're going to need a large socket to remove this one. At this point, your swing arm is free, okay? And you can place the new one. What I like to show you, in my old swing arm, I had a broken part right here. I had the broken part right here, like a big cut. And this was the part that was holding the exhaust. I tried to, you can bring it to a professional place where they weld this stuff together, okay? But if you find a newer part, like a new part online, like a scooters, part.com, partsforscooters.com, you can buy online, you can buy brand new parts, because even if someone is really, really good and he weld this part in a nice way, not like me, because I'm not really a professional in welding. I try to do my best. I have a welding machine, but really the job didn't come up perfectly. I try to do my best. So, look, that's the part that it was broken, okay? Now, for like 6 months, it was okay, and then we broke again. Now, I decided to find a new part with partsforscooters.com, and I found this one. How about that? Looks fantastic. So this one is going to fit nicely in the scooter and has two nice right here studs to hold your exhaust, okay? Now they also give you the spacer for your scooter, so you can put it right there, new spacers, okay? So that's what the scooters, partsforscooters.com, they will give you spacer and a brand new part, okay? At this point, looks good. This is the new part, and we are ready to put it in the rear side of your scooter, okay? Looks pretty good. Partsforscooter.com, right here. So, make sure you enter first the two sides right here, because if not, you have the dipstick that doesn't let you in. So put this side first, and then you put the other side. So, enter. And then you put the hole right here. Make sure that everything match, okay? Try to keep the spring and the shock from the back out of the way, okay? Don't worry, later we're gonna think about that part right there. For now, we make sure we put the screws back here, they're 12 millimeter, we're gonna put them inside, okay? And there is another right up here, but you know, up here you also have this part right here, there's like a shape, triangular shape, that is the part of the rear fender. This long screw right here, they're 12 millimeter. Make sure when you screw these bolts, make sure they're not forcing. If they're forcing, go back, see what's wrong. Don't keep screwing something in that is forcing, because if it's forcing, it might break something, okay? Okay, this one is one. Look like this new swing arm is sitting at the best. It's sitting really perfectly, I love it. really have to thank that company at the moment. So they saved me. I went online and one auction site, very popular, and I found one of these pottery. It was a $900. So I got that crazy. So anyway, if you go to their website, is partsforscooters.com, you find this one at a really good price. Okay, they really saved my life. Okay. I'm not here to push in their company. They don't give me nothing, but you know, when someone does their job and they do it great and they give me good product, I really bless them, okay? So make sure you tie this screws as much as you can. Do not tie it too much, because if not you're gonna break something, okay? You're gonna untray them, okay? Now when we are at this point, you can place back the nut right here, okay? I will put a spacer there just to make sure it's gonna go the right way, the way I want it. I have a little spacer right here. That's it, it's gonna sit perfectly, okay? Okay, at this point we can place the big nut right here, rear side, where is your wheel. Be gently, always start by hand. You don't wanna have the impact wrench driving the big nut for you inside, because if it goes on the side, we might unscrew the treading. If you unscrew the treading, you're really gonna be in trouble. So do the job by hand at the beginning, and then later you're going to use the impact wrench, okay? At this point, you can keep doing, you can put the socket a little bit, and you can turn it by hand. No, I love the impact wrenches, okay? I love it, they're nice, you know, but it's like, sometimes there's too much force and they will untread the nut, or they will untread the other side of the nut, so that you're gonna have a problem. So make sure when you reassemble, you turn right, okay? When you unscrew, you turn left. How about that? This is a nice, okay, this is a nice little impact wrench. You can have a little fun with it, this one. It's not really the best of the best, but it works, okay? Okay, the next thing we need to work on is the rear shaft right here. You have a 12 millimeter bolt right here, okay? Now, it's not gonna be so easy to put it back on, okay? Because kind of the spring is pushing down, the shock is pushing down, and you need to put a screw there. But you only have one person job, okay? One person, unless you have somebody helping out. If somebody can help you out, you can push the scooter from the rack right there, from the back rack, push the scooter up, and that will help you with this spring going up a little bit for you. So you can put this screw inside there, okay? Now, what you can do, if you're by yourself, you just place a screwdriver, flat screwdriver, on the back side, where's the U shape of the spring, and you can put this one inside back there and make it a lever, okay? So it's gonna help to push the spring up for you, okay? So that's what you have to do right there, okay? Little by little, you need to find a way to push the spring up and put the spring at the position where you can enter the bolt. Okay, right after you place this bolt right here, you can start to screw in with the 12 millimeter socket. You can start to screw the bolt in with the 12 millimeter socket. Okay. Make sure it's nice and tight back here. Don't over tight, because you might lose the threading. Because if you lose the threading, you have a big problem. Okay, you might need a new shock. Or what you can do, you can put like, if you lose the threading, you can put a nut behind the shock in the back, and you can tie it with a nut in the back. But tight the shock, do not over tight. It's a lot better to do another job, okay? Okay, at this point, the only thing you need to put back is your exhaust. And you only need 2 40 millimeter here and 2 10 millimeter underneath the scooter. At this point, we just finished to change the swing arm in the back for your scooter. This swing arm looks fantastic. I'm really happy about it. And if you need some swing arm like that, just make sure you go to partsforscooter.com and you will find a nice swing arm like that for a good price, let me tell you. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you very much for watching. Feel free to subscribe anytime. Click like if you really like this video, okay? And if you have any questions, feel free to ask. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.